She was Ronald Reagan's strongest supporter, his sharpest negotiator, his lifelong protector. Tonight, the CNN original series First Ladies looks at the life of Nancy Reagan.
Reagan carries an unprecedented 49 states in the 84 election. And Nancy's eye turns towards securing his legacy.
In 1997, I asked her, was there some area that you felt you had an effect? And she said, oh, no, no. Ronnie knew exactly what he wanted to do from the moment he was elected. And then she paused and very, very softly added, well, maybe the whole Russian thing. And I was like, the whole Russian thing? You mean the main thing of his administration?
Joining us now, Ron Reagan, son of the former president and first lady. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Your mother is credited as being so instrumental to your father's political career. She was often called the brains of the operation. What was the dynamic like between them in private with your family growing up?
Unaffected affection. My mother and father really just loved each other. They couldn't keep their hands off each other in private. They were always telling one another that they loved each other. And so I grew up in an atmosphere of a very romantic couple.
Which sounds wonderful. But again, she was involved in, you know, what he was doing as president. I just wonder, did that involvement in White House matters extend to the family, to you and your siblings, the way it does with this current White House?
No, not the way it does in this current White House. No, it would be terribly inappropriate, and I'm sure my father would have thought so, to practice the kind of nepotism that we see now. I mean, he would not be of a mind to appoint an unqualified person, whether that person was his child or not, to a position high in the White House. Again, given no experience there, why would you do that? Why would I even accept something like that?
So here you are now, an outspoken liberal, despite your father being a Republican icon. You weren't just his son. You share the same name. Did you feel any added pressure to follow his path, or was there actually more pressure to veer from that path, to chart your own?
I didn't really feel any pressure either way. I was never particularly interested in participating in politics as a politician. People would always ask me the question, of course. So there was no pressure. There was certainly no pressure within the family to do that. And in fact, I think my father was probably relieved that I didn't go in that direction.
I guess, what are your thoughts, or what's your impression of how we've seen the President Trump's children, and their involvement in his administration and his campaign?
Well, they're certainly entitled to go campaign for their dad. My eldest brother and sister did that, and there's nothing wrong with that. When you cross the line is I hate to say it here, and I don't mean to be blunt, but we've got a bunch of grifters there in the White House. They're treating this as a grift, and that is no good.
How do you see it that way?
How do I see it that way? They're mixing business with pleasure, let's say. They're mixing business with statecraft. They're using the hotels and the golf clubs to profit off the presidency. The Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump have no qualifications whatsoever to be in the position they're in. Zero. Zip. And they're using it to make money, basically.
We learned this week Maryland's Republican governor, Larry Hogan, cast a write-in vote for your father in the 2020 election, and he told the Washington Post, I know it's simply symbolic, it's not going to change the outcome in my state, but I thought it was important to just cast a vote that showed the kind of person I'd like to see in office. I asked CNN presidential historian Douglas Brinkley about that, and he made this prediction.
I think if Donald Trump loses, that you'll see the Republican Party go back to saying we're the party of Ronald Reagan. You know, Reagan has been kind of downplayed by Donald Trump. He was really the golden person of the Republican Party, and suddenly he seems second tier. But without Donald Trump, and you're seeing Senator Sasse doing the same thing, basically reclaiming a rebranded Republican Party for 2021 as a conservative party of Ronald Reagan.
Ron, what's your reaction to that?
I don't think the Republican Party or any other party can profit by looking backwards. We have to look forwards. Whatever party you belong to, you have to look to the future, particularly now. We're at a crucial point in history. I think everybody feels that. This is one of those nodal points in history where we're going to take one fork or we're going to take the other. It's going to be a dark road or it's going to be a more progressive road. So I don't think going back to the days of Ronald Reagan is the answer for the Republican Party, but they don't have much else. They really don't have much else. And Donald Trump has done a tremendous amount of damage to this party. When I think of my father, I think of words like integrity, decency, dignity, honor, and patriotism, not nationalism, but patriotism. All of those qualities are in very short supply in this White House. And frankly, the Republican Party has been complicit in degrading those values.
Do you think your father would recognize the Republican Party right now?
He would be horrified by the Republican Party right now. The spinelessness in the face of this pathological entity in the White House right now would shock him.
George W. Bush has stayed silent on the race so far. If your father were alive today, do you think he would say something publicly and pick a side?
I have no idea what my father would do publicly. I can't speak for him that way. I know his character, and I know what would horrify him, and I know that this administration would. But beyond that, I can't say what he would do.
Well, Ron Reagan, it's a pleasure to talk with you. Thank you for sharing your insights about your family and the state of our country right now. And again, we're looking forward to hearing more about your mother tonight in our new episode of First Ladies, all about the life and legacy of Nancy Reagan. It airs tonight at 10, right here on CNN.